Ready, Mount St. Mary's and New Orleans, the first of our first four matchup here tonight. Just moments ago in the locker room of New Orleans, head coach Mark Schlesinger.
Be you, be blue collar, be the hardest working team we got. Be the best blue collar team we can be today. And we all know the toughest team wins every time. The toughest team wins every time. So do everything it takes to be the toughest team every single second we're out there. All right?
Yes, sir.
Can we smile a little bit?
Let's get it!
Well, Mark Schlesinger says, have an undefeated attitude every day. Got to put that on a T-shirt. That is quotable for sure. Mm-hmm. Mark Schlesinger, year number six. And for Mount St. Mary's, it is a guy who starred at this university, Jamian Christian. He had a year under Shaka Smart with VCU, was in this tournament. His third occasion here for the university, his second as a head coach. Now, both of these coaches deal, this is something very near and dear to my heart, Clark, they deal with the short version of NCAA basketball. Mount St. Mary's has the shortest player in Junior Robinson. Kristavius Gill is at 5'8 for New Orleans. I am very intrigued about this matchup. And for more on the smallest player in Division I, we check in with Lewis Johnson. Good evening, Lewis.
Yeah, Junior, the smallest guy in Division I, and of course, the smallest guy in the Madness. Now, for those watching at home, it may be a little hard to really understand how small he is. So yesterday, after the shoot-around, I walked over and I said, Junior, do you have a minute? Can we take a photo together? And he was a great sport. Here's what happened. Look at that. Now, I'm 6 feet, 6 inches tall, and there's Junior at 5'5", and you can see right there the incredible difference, incredibly how short he is. But now the question is, can he rise up off the floor? And here's your answer. 5'5", going down the court, and I mean, he floats up to 10 feet for that dunk, and that was, again, a loss against Lehigh earlier in the season. Robinson told me that he started dunking as a sophomore in high school, Alamance High School there in North Carolina, and he was only 5'4 back then. And earlier in the season at a game at Iowa State, a student section gave him a standing ovation for his pregame dunking performance, and he did some things here as well. So look, a small guy ready to do big things in March Madness. How about that?
I love it. I've already found my favorite player of the tournament already, Junior Robinson. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. And Clark, quickly, what are some of the matchups you got your eyes on here?
Well, obviously, ball screen offense for Junior Robinson and Elijah Long. That's what New Orleans is going to have to defend inside. Can Eric Thomas have his way, as he has done pretty much against every opponent all season?
The Mount bringing their mayhem, and Junior Robinson, he and Eli Young, their two star, Eli Long, I should say, their star players. We're ready to tip it off here. Great to have you with us from Dayton, Ohio. Brent Hampton, Jeb Hartness, Steve McJunkins are our three officials, and we are underway. The NCAA tournament has arrived, folks.
And looking forward to this matchup. A lot of ball screen action you'll see with Elijah Long and Robinson trying to penetrate.
Kristavius Gill with the steal and going up top. Wow, flying high was McCoor Poe, fouled in the process. And it is the team that's supposed to be the ball control that starts with a little up-tempo.
Off the turnover, Gill to Poe, and he almost punched that one home.
Chris Ray called for the foul. McCoor Poe, a junior from Sudan at 6'9". A 51% free throw shooter, trying to get the first points on the board in this NCAA tournament. Since the format began here in 2011, the first four format, one team playing in the first four has advanced to the round of 32. And the most famous of those teams was VCU, which went from the first four to the final four. And while Javon Christian had a tenure at VCU, that was the year after that final four team. So winning here, Clark, can give you a little momentum as you enter into the full field beginning on Thursday.
Nothing like having a game under your belt and a victory to go with it.
On the take, Miles Wilson comes up short. Always a lot of anxiety, a lot of feeling out process as we get a steal from Wilson.
But Thomas that time very casual with the ball, B.A.
Always seems to take a minute to settle in. And you can tell both of these teams are playing a little nervous to start this game.
Nothing wrong with that. Hey, the butterflies just have to get lined up and fly in the same direction. That's what we see right now. Both teams a little jittery, but they'll smooth it out. A little full court pressure here by the Mount. They like to force turnovers, utilize the quickness. Not a very big team, not a strong rebounding team, so they try to disrupt with quickness and pressure.
Oh, nice pass. Thibodeau dropped it in beautifully to Eric Thomas. Eric Thomas is a player to watch. 14 in white for New Orleans, averaging nearly 20 points per game. The conference player of the year in the Southland Conference.
And Thibodeau leads this team in assists. He's a power forward, but an excellent passer.
Junior Robinson works the point with Long. Nice dish inside. Missing the dunk is Salah. Now gets it back. Mountaineers at 19 and 15 this year. They went 14 and 4 in their conference. And winning not just the regular season, but the NEC tournament as well. Wilson on the tape, comes up short. Here come the Privateers. Gill all the way in with the left, finishes strong. Talking about one of the short players on the floor at 5'8".
Small doesn't mean you can't ball. We showed Keon Johnson in that graphic as well, along with Junior Robinson and Christavius Gill. All three of those guys, dynamic scores.
Chris Ray gives it up in the corner, and a big hit by Wilson. Now, this team can shoot the three ball.
Yeah.
Talking to Javon Christian earlier today, he said, we haven't even played our best basketball. We have a lot more in us. We feel like we can shoot the ball from behind the arc and give ourselves a fighting chance this tournament.
They make 7 threes per game on average, but he feels like they've got a 10 or 11 three-point field goal make game. As we look at Christavius Gill right to the rim, and then a good push here, and Miles Wilson able to knock down that three-pointer. I like this young man's game, only a freshman, but extremely smooth in how he operates.
They see the profile of Mount St. Mary's from Emmitsburg, Maryland, just south of the Mason-Dixon line. It's about an hour from Washington, D.C. This is a school that started at 1-11 this season, and 9 straight games on the road. Those bye games. Here's Gill once again, proving he's not afraid early. In and out of the hands and out of bounds off of Michael Zeno. Their non-conference schedule, Mount St. Mary's, included West Virginia, Iowa State, Minnesota, Michigan, Arkansas, all in the first 9 games, all on the road.
And it was interesting, Coach Christian told us he knew his team was going to challenge for the championship because of how they responded to those losses.
George Rosa hits a 3 for the Privateers. That run of teams I gave you on Mount St. Mary's, all of those teams in the NCAA tournament. And Javon Christian feels like that's going to give them a little bit of a boost. So a nice run here to start it for the Privateers of New Orleans, partner.
Yep, good ball movement here. A late closeout by Wilson. And Rosa makes him pay.
Foul called on Michael Zeno. Sixth year coach, Mark Schlesinger, hometown of Bloomington, Indiana. Coach Schles. And what a program he has been able to turn this into. Inside, breaking free is Wilson. Miles Wilson, the freshman from the Baltimore area. Inside, Thibodeau. And he's met at the rim by Alexander and a foul.
Well, that time, B.A., you saw full court pressure applied by Mount St. Mary's. Again, they're going to try to utilize their quickness to force turnovers because they are in a distinct size disadvantage, so they don't want the Privateers to be able to play comfortably in the half court. They want to try to speed them up.
And Thibodeau hits the first, and we remind you to watch live games on your computer, your phone, your tablet, or your streaming device with NCAA March Madness Live. Watch now at ncaa.com/marchmadness or download the app today. We will have Kansas State and Wake Forest in the second of our doubleheader here tonight to get the NCAA tournament started. And this crowd here in Dayton will start to file in as we get to halftime and into the second half of this game, and it'll be a great environment here at this arena and the traditional home of the first four. They're excited to have you back. A nice easy drive for you.
It's a comfortable drive, about 90 miles from the home front for me, and I'm pleased to be back, excited to be back. Did the first couple of first fours here back in 2011 and 12 and thoroughly enjoyed it. Great basketball community here in the Dayton area, and they do a tremendous job supporting this event and the student athletes and institutions that participate in.
Rosa dumps it inside. Michael Zeno and puts one off the window. So you're seeing the strength of New Orleans getting inside. Even though they've hit a three, they want to play the old school kind of game. We asked Mark Schlesinger who your influence is. He said, maybe John Wooden. Three guards, two post players, dump it inside and take your chances with your big men. And a nice answer inside by Mauro Sala.
I tell you, that's a bonus for Mount St. Mary. He's capable, but they don't give him many touches. They rely a lot on their perimeter guys, and Thibodeau rounding out. And here's this nice-looking freshman, Brian. Miles Wilson handles the ball, moves well without it. Nice pass there.
Junior Robinson hits a three. And so Mount St. Mary's gives you a taste of what they want to do throughout this game. A drive and a pitch. Inside Zeno again. The foul, no shot. Foul's on the floor. And it'll be Mount St. Mary's ball when we continue. We're off and running. The NCAA tournament has arrived. Dayton, Ohio, Mount St. Mary's against New Orleans. Stretch Clark, and yep. That is a very familiar song when you get into the NCAA tournament, especially for a team that's going into that 16 spot and will take on Villanova.
And a team that's undersized. Both teams have made four buckets, and they've assisted on all of their makes. Good start both ways.
I'm sure Mount St. Mary's would like to get Eli Long in the mix here shortly. One and done for the Mountaineers. Alexander missing on the three.
Got a good look at it, though.
Well, now New Orleans will get into their set. This is a team that has won 8 of their last 10. A hot team to get into this tournament, including a win over Texas A&M Corpus Christi in Katy, Texas on Saturday in the Southland Championship. And a block underneath will result in free throws for Tevin Broyles. So, Clark, we touched on it a little bit. Lewis has more on this story, but this was a university ravaged by Hurricane Katrina in 2005. It was one of the largest universities in Louisiana. And all of a sudden, as a commuter school, their population dwindles. And then they were in a position, as Schlesinger took over the program, where they were thinking about going Division II or maybe Division III. He took the job without knowing where they were headed, and yet here they are, 2017. He took over in 11, and they've made it to the NCAA tournament.
And he talked to us about being relentlessly positive, relentlessly optimistic, and clearly he's embodied that, and he's passed it on to his players. And they're one of the biggest turnarounds from last year to this year in terms of wins. Top 10, 9.5 more victories than a year ago. And so credit to these kids and to the coaching staff and Coach Schlesinger's leadership.
Cannot tell you what a game like this means for programs like this, but especially New Orleans, to have this moment on a national stage in the NCAA tournament as this rebuild has gone on. Katrina's devastated so many outlets. And yeah, here we are 12 years later, and there's still some of the repercussions. But this program, to make it here, it is a phenomenal story to get to this point for the Privateers.
It really is a beacon of light and inspiration on a number of levels for not just the university, but New Orleans in total.
Eli Long will sit with two fouls, so Junior Robinson will run the point for the Mount. And Wilson, who's been the best player so far in this game, at least the most comfortable in this game, is fouled. And they're going to get George Rosa on the call.
Well, that's a big loss for Mount St. Mary's because Elijah Long handles the ball so much along with Junior Robinson. And Jamie and Christian loves having two point guards out there at all times to keep constant pressure on the defense. And utilize the ball skills and shooting ability of those guards to create offense.
Saw Kristaps Gill check back in. Nate Frye on the floor as well for the Privateers of New Orleans. And here's Wilson, a little hesitation, runs right into the double team. Robinson left wide open. He can fill it up from three, and he launches a bomb and knocks it down. Junior Robinson scored 22 in the championship game of the NEC against St. Francis. That was a 10-point win. And that's going the other way. Offensive foul will give it back to the Mountaineers.
How about the pass here? The diagonal, when you're facing a shifting defense, getting that ball diagonally from one corner to the side is a great way to get your teammate an open shot. Part of an 8-0 run for the Mount.
Robinson shoots it at 40% from behind the arc. He finished third in the conference. Bullet pass inside. And with a little hesitation, the layup rolls in. Chris Ray. Well, the assist from Robinson. Well, the middle was wide open for the Mountaineers. And we got a whistle inside. Let's see who they're going to get from Mount St. Mary's. Good action from Nate Frye. Going to get Alexander his second foul.
Here's Junior Robinson doing a nice job penetrating with his head up. Good up fake to send Poe to the Paratroopers Club. Ray able to finish inside.
Nate Frye will shoot the free throws. Backup point guard. Shoots it at nearly 80%. And Clark, here comes Eli Long now with two fouls.
I like this move though, Brian. He's a guy that you count on to be able to play with fouls, although he's only a sophomore. He's just got to be careful, but it shouldn't always be automatic that when a player gets two fouls that he sits. It's a matter of how much the coach trusts him and what kind of role he has on the team, whether you take him out or let him play with two fouls.
One out of two free throws, snaps that 8-0 run for Mount St. Mary's.
But right now, Mount St. Mary's playing the style they enjoy more and better than what the Privateers want to do. Pace and space, penetrate and pitch, and knock down threes. So, terrific start here for the Mountaineers.
Back-to-back threes. Robinson first, and then Wilson with the answer. 18-11. Mount St. Mary's out of the NEC. Up seven, and looking for a counter is Frye. No, one and done, and the shortest guy on the floor flying high for the rebound. Young and Robinson together. That usually leaves Wilson with some open space.
Nice look at pass. This
in the corner, we got a foul. We got a block on the pass. I think Mount St. Mary's would rather have the open shot.
I think you're right.
And that'll take us to a timeout, Clark.
Well, it's all Mount St. Mary's thus far. Penetrate, pitch, and let it fly. Tournament, not just the big names that we're familiar with. This is one of those outstanding newbies, I call them, neon newbies, and you're seeing him perform at a high level here tonight.
Yeah, not afraid of the bright lights. He's got a turnover, and New Orleans cannot convert. They have now missed their last six shots.
And a couple of them have been right at the rim. Eric Thomas had a good look a couple of possessions ago that he overshot.
And so that'll go the other way. And Jamie and Christian and Mount St. Mary's starting to establish their kind of pace here. Eli Long running the point. Another guy from the Maryland area. Went to prep school in Maryland. He is a Canadian. He's from Ontario. New Orleans jumped out to a 10-5 lead. They made four of their first five shots. 0-for-6 since. And we got a whistle with four on the shot clock. And Jamie and Christian's going to get Chris Ray in. I think Christian was feeling a little anxious with Long out there and two fouls and 10:34 left in this first half.
And you're plus seven on the scoreboard too, Brian. So a good move there to give him a chance to relax a bit.
Working inside, a little jump hook not there for Sala. One and done on this end. Thibodeau yanks down the rebound.
Let's see if the Privateers can get that ball inside. Try to get Thomas going. He's not going to force it, though. He does not hunt shots, and he doesn't hog the ball, so he plays within himself. Ooh. Beautiful move there.
Wow, athletic move to the hole. Kristaps Gill averages a little over 11 and a half per game. Gill is a deadly three-point shooter as well. And dump it inside once again. Sala kicks it out. There's Thibodeau. Thibodeau saves it. And New Orleans is on the move. Thomas wide open. Good look. And in transition, the Privateers.
What a play. The two passes prior to the scoring pass were phenomenal. I mean, that saving pass got the ball to half court. And then the immediate look up by Gill to the running Thomas.
Thibodeau, 25 and white. He was on the Southland Conference all defensive team this year. Top 10 in the conference in steals and playing mostly in the front court. Good pass, nice hang by Wilson. Boy, he's got a lot to his game.
He sure does. That book bag is full.
All this talk about Long and Junior Robinson, and it is Miles Wilson who has stepped up in the bright lights thus far. 5-point lead for Mount St. Mary's. Approaching the 9-minute mark. First four underway. First game of our doubleheader tonight. Nothing there for Poe. Going the other way. Let's see who they get. They're going to get Thibodeau.
Great opportunity here for the Privateers. More of this would serve them well and finishing. I think they've gotten a couple of good opportunities in the half court, Brian, inside, but they just haven't converted them. They have to continue to throw it in there and finish a little better.
See, they've assisted on six of their field goals on five occasions, and that's really the name of their game. They want to move the ball, and you see a lot of touches. And I'm sure Eric Thomas is anxious to get loose here. And a friendly bounce for Junior Robinson. Robinson, a top 10 scorer in the NEC this year, averaging 14 a game. Long averaging nearly 15 and a half a game. And a hot pass, too hot, inside, turnover. Taken right back by Poe. Inside Thomas, shot clock ticks, and with five, New Orleans gets an easy basket.
Nice job of being patient that time by Poe. He let that cut develop for Thomas after the loose ball was retrieved.
Robinson to pull it back. It's a good story here for Mount St. Mary's with Eli Long with two fouls, Greg Alexander with two fouls, and yet they've been able to maintain their lead. Played a little more ball control than you would normally see. Wilson, no. And Poe pulls down the board. Gill will pull from long range. And it's Sala with the rebound on the other end. Early shot for New Orleans. And that's going to be out of bounds off of Poe. That'll be Mount St. Mary's basketball when we continue. The NCAA tournament and the first four is off and running. You big guys never dreamed of being little guys, but
I did not.
It is a pleasure to watch Junior Robinson play this game at 5'5". He's a junior. He's a North Carolina native, and he is a flat scorer. And if you weren't with us in the open, Lewis Johnson, our reporter, gave you video of a dunk in a game, a two-handed jam in a game by the 5'5 Robinson. He's got a 40-inch vertical, and he'll fire with four on the shot clock. In and out it goes, and now New Orleans with a chance to cut into this deficit. For all of you on social media right now, Lewis Johnson has reported that he is posting that dunk on Twitter.
Very impressive.
Second screen. And True TV posted that as well. So
good active hands and a turnover. And this guy who's been superb, Miles Wilson. Nothing rushed about his game. Everything smooth.
Had a double-double in the NEC Championship, 15 and 10. 12 of those 15 points came in the second half. First career double-double. Well, Miles Wilson now, too much dribbling and lost the handle.
You called it. He did a little bit of what I call treadmill dribbling. Something was moving, but wasn't going anywhere.
And there's a big hit for Eric Thomas. He needed to see one go through.
Well, he doesn't miss too many now. This guy, again, he does not force shots. He shoots over close to 60%, 59% from the floor is what he shoots, and he doesn't get it all in the paint. Mid-range jump shot, gets to the line a lot, and I love the fact that he doesn't force shots.
Salah got a good pass from Robinson. He is fouled. He'll head to the line.
Eric Thompson, Thomas, the player of the year in the Southland. Here he is. Takes his time, never in a hurry, and then gets a quality shot. And again, he makes 59% of his shots from the floor, and they are not all in the paint.
A 49% free throw shooter is Mauro Salah. And changes here for New Orleans. George Rosa is in, Makor Poe as well. Gill will sit for the time being. By the way, Thomas has scored the last 6 points for New Orleans, and they've cut into that deficit. One out of two for Mauro Salah. 4-point game. Just under 6 minutes to go. Just underway. First of our NCAA tournament matchups. We got Kansas State and Wake Forest. Danny Manning's Demon Deacons will be in the second of our doubleheader. And we got a foul, and that's going the other way. They're going to get Thomas.
Wow.
On the foul after the miss. His first.
He was trying to retrieve his miss. He knew he had shot it short. And I thought that was just a good effort trying to get to the ball. Didn't see the foul.
One and one coming. Mount St. Mary's in the bonus here. And Wilson, a 75% free throw shooter, knocks the first one down. Well, first round coverage of the NCAA Division I Women's Basketball Championship begins Friday on ESPN2. And watch ESPN for more information. You can go to NCAA.com. Long range three after the miss. Will Miller, offensive board and a putback for Salah. Nice trip down the floor.
It's true. For a team that typically gets out rebounded by 7 a game, Brian, they're winning the glass thus far. Are the Mountaineers.
The winner of this game will have a date Thursday in Buffalo against Villanova, the overall number one seed. That'll be Thursday night on CBS. And a mid-range pull from Broyles.
And I think that was a settle. You've got a size advantage. You want to make sure you at least look inside when you're in the half court if you're the Privateers. That was a one-pass mid-range jumper.
Wilson to the line. Foul on Poe. That's what the bracket looks like. So that Wisconsin-Virginia Tech is an interesting matchup. And how about Wisconsin, a 2 seed at the Big Ten tournament, slipping to an 8 seed in the NCAA tournament?
Yeah, I was mildly surprised by that. I thought they would fall in that 5-6 range. Virginia Tech, a high-octane offensive team.
The birthplace of aviation, Dayton, Ohio, and a great presence from the Air Force here in Dayton and here in this arena enjoying this first four matchup. A lot of tickets were offered to the United States Air Force members, and they have taken up the offer and enjoying a little March Madness basketball in Dayton. We welcome all of them, and we thank all of them and all of our service members who allow us to enjoy this great tournament with freedom.
Well said. Well said and much appreciated.
Couple of free throws there for Wilson. He continues to score it well. Leads all scorers with 12 points. Mount St. Mary's back up 8. New Orleans with the ball.
And they've really yet to assert themselves inside. They've already taken 6 three-point field goal attempts, and they average only 14 attempts from behind the arc per game. One of the fewest in the country. So this is where they want to work, inside.
Another late clock situation. Thomas just did get it off.
Well challenged as he shot it, Brian.
And a 3-point try is up and good. Will Miller, a senior from Dallas. He was on Mount St. Mary's squad that played here as a freshman in 2014. Made 7 three-pointers.
Loves this gym. Loves this building. And his team is playing at a really high level, making threes and surprisingly winning the backboards handily thus far.
Zeno answers on the other end. A good minutes in the Southland Conference Tournament. New Orleans needed that basket in a big way. 9-point game, Mount St. Mary's with the ball and the lead. And their 5'5 point guard, Junior Robinson, running the show with Eli Long on the bench. with two fouls. Long three, Wilson. If he knocks that one down, we've got a full halftime package ready for Clark on Wilson there. We might have it anyway.
Exactly. Mount St. Mary's doing a nice job pressuring the ball, not allowing it to get inside, sloughing off, knowing that the privateers don't really want to shoot the perimeter shot. Well, thus far, it's pretty much been all.
He was in the midst of moving from Division I to Division II, a process that he told me takes about 3 years. So he had about 6 months to decide if they should remain D1 or slip on down to D2. But he said he really came up with three reasons why the university should remain Division I. Number one, he said, we are the University of New Orleans. We represent a major international city. Two, we are a major international sports city. And then finally, he said they had just come out of Hurricane Katrina, and they needed to be recognized as a live, thriving, progressive university. He said back then, 5 years ago, it was the right decision, and believes the same now.
Well, it is a fantastic story. And Clark, as we touched on, this event, I mean, there are a lot of ways to build up a university, but it's hard to beat the punch that is offered at the NCAA tournament.
Oh, without question. I mean, it's a grand stage. It's a galvanizing type of an event. There you see Thomas working as well as any guy his size in the country inside, and quick attack that time. But to continue on, you think about the benefits of this kind of exposure and the return from the ashes in a sense when you talk about that decision to stay Division I, and it's ended in a great way.
New Orleans been able to fight back, now down five, and with nine on the shot clock, Mount St. Mary's will cover. Gill with a good defensive play. And back comes Elijah Long now. Again, he's been with two fouls, sitting for a good part of this half. They've had the luxury. Jamie and Christian has had a nice lead to work with, and he has certainly bought some time for his star. Yeah, Robinson for three, short. Offensive board, Ray, put back is good. Second chance opportunity for the Mount.
Well, I tell you, that's the story of the first half for me. A team that typically gets beat on the glass by seven a game, out-rebounding a team that usually out-rebounds its opponents by three. And you knew the three-point shooting would be an advantage for Mount St. Mary's, but the rebounding has really been a plus.
Ray finds Robinson inside to out, and can't hit the three.
Boy, he wanted that one. But that was good offense there, and he got a quality look at it.
Gill goes right by Robinson, maybe thinking about the missed shot too
much.
Wow,
he made it tougher than it had to be.
And now the putback by Broyles, so an easy basket inside for the Privateers of New Orleans.
Gill had a layup on the left side of the hoop and went up and under, but thankfully a teammate bailed him out there.
Well, perhaps on Thursday, if you advance in this game, you're going to need a little English running into the big boys of Villanova, but not here today. Steal by Thomas on the run with Robinson, who disrupts the transition, and Thomas scores the basket, and suddenly New Orleans making a run here at the end of the first half.
Well, I've watched this team a couple of times. They don't run, they don't go away. They were down in the conference championship game by seven at halftime and found a way to fight to the victory in overtime. So this team stays with it.
The Mount had an 11-point lead. Shot clock to six, had it knocked away. Got to get one up quick. Robinson takes a look. Little crossover, long range three, no. And here comes Thomas. Shot clock is off. From down 11 to down three with a chance to either tie or get within one. This is a 10-2 New Orleans run.
Fueled by defense, active hands, a couple of turnovers, and breakouts.
Eric Thomas gives it up. Gill, he'll pull the three. Offensive board. And at the buzzer, no, the tap-in will not count. Wave it off. And that's how the first game of the NCAA tournament comes to a close in the first half. 3-point lead, Mount St. Mary's. But a nice run for New Orleans to fight their way back. A 10-2 run to end the half. Miles Wilson leads all scorers for Mount with 12. Thomas with 12 as well. Let's Check in with Lewis Johnson.
All right, Coach, well, after the Butterflies finally settled down, how do you think your team played, and especially with the way you guys rebounded here in the first quarter?
They did a great job. Got in some foul trouble there, so I had to play some unconventional lineups. Good thing for me, I got a lot of veteran guys that can come in and play a lot of different roles for us. Really happy with our rebounding.
All right, so now New Orleans has climbed back into this game. What's going to be important in the second half?
Well, we just got to continue to rebound the ball, really make sure we stick to our game plan, take care of the basketball offensively. We've given a lot of points in transition. We knew they're electric there. We do a great job there. I like our team.
All right, Coach, thanks.
Thank you so much.
BA.
All right, Lewis, thanks. And our thanks to Jamie and Christian about St. Mary's. Stay tuned for eight.
Oops, and they had four straight deflections, which helped them get back in this game. What is he looking for in this game? More shots like that, more opportunities off deflections to get easy baskets, to get back in this thing and take the lead. PA?
All right, good stuff, Lewis. And by the way, you saw that mic flag that Lewis is holding, and all of the reporters during the NCAA tournament. Sager strong. We lost our great friend Craig Sager, and his favorite event was this NCAA tournament this time of year, and we're thinking about Sags and all the contributions, Clark, that he made to this wonderful event.
No question about it. Thinking about him, his family, and the impact he had on all that he encountered and had a chance to relate to and with.
We echo the sentiments of our crew in Atlanta, and you'll see all the reporters throughout the NCAA tournament on this family of networks, CBS and the Turner Sports family, with those Sager strong mic flags. So we get the second half underway. That's going to be an offensive foul, and New Orleans will turn it over. Thibodeau picks up his third foul now. And four turnovers, check it, for UNO, three turnovers in the first 7.5 minutes, Clark, of the first half. They had just one in the final 12 and a half. And as Lewis mentioned, that was a big part of that 10-2 run for New Orleans to get back into this game. They were down 11 at one point. And now Wilson, who was the star of that first half, dribbles it out of bounds. It's going to be out on Thibodeau. And it'll remain in the possession of Mount St. Mary's. Well, you look around this arena now and starting to fill in. It'll be a packed house, and it's getting close to that right now. And this is where it gets very exciting. We get to the second half of the first game. Kansas State, Wake Forest coming up in game number two. A couple of 11 seeds. And four teams trying to enter into the full field. Robinson goes to the hole, pitches it out. Wilson for three, knocks it down.
3-point basket, Miles Wilson.
High pick and roll, Brian, right in the middle of the floor. You get that initial penetration. Defense has to collapse. Corner shooters spaced out and stationary, and Wilson splashes it.
15 points for the freshman. A turnaround. Poe hits it.
McCour
Poe averages nearly six a game. He's got a little mid-range game in him. And a nice turnaround to score the basket for New Orleans. Four-point game. Mount St. Mary's with the lead in Navy. Winners of the Northeast Conference Tournament. Also the regular season champs. Robinson goes to the hole. High off the window. Scores. And almost a takeaway. Going to get a foul, actually. So the foul called on Broyles.
High pick and roll action. This is what Mount St. Mary's likes to do. Junior Robinson splitting defenders and then dropping the dime. And then the high arcing shot. When you're only 5'5", you've got to have all of those high floaters to be able to get it up and down.
And that vertical leap that gets him in places you're not expecting from a player of that height surprises you. Look out. A swat by McCour Poe into the third row. First block of the game for New Orleans.
Nicely timed that time by Poe.
Matter of fact, first block of the game for either team. Both of these teams showcase some shot blockers. Shot clock down to seven. Kick to the corner. Robinson's wide open. And Junior hits another one.
Beautiful play to get that penetration and look for the open shooter and then get the pass there on time and on target. Nicely done.
He's having a nice shooting day here, Robinson. 5 for 9 from the field. 3 for 6 from behind the arc. sitting on 13 points.
Well, Jamie and Christian told us he felt like his team was ready to explode for a double-digit three-point make night.
In the corner, Gill comes up short, poked away by Long. And Long gets it back in transition. Robinson, oh, he kicked it out of bounds. He had heat coming on him in McCoor Poe. He lost it.
I think he was thinking about what he was going to do with it before he caught it.
I know what he wanted to do.
I know exactly what he wanted to do. Coming right at you.
Oh, man.
And he was ready to make his move before he squeezed the orange.
Seriously, Clark, if he throws that down at 5-5 like he wanted to, that would be the moment of the tournament for a while.
Well, we still might get a chance to see one.
He might have that chance.
Full court pressure here.
And New Orleans breaks it inside. Thibodeau goes strong with the left.
Dragon Thibodeau.
That's exactly what you have to do against a team that applies pressure. Attack it for scores. Don't attack it to just set up your offense. Make them pay for pressing by getting it to the paint.
First field goal for Draven Thibodeau. Now a steal. And an easy finish for Nate Frye. Suddenly, turnovers for Mount St. Mary's turning into baskets for New Orleans.
Much like we saw at the end of that first half, Brian. That 10-2 run was fueled by a handful of deflections by the Privateers.
And that answered an 8-0 run by Mount St. Mary's to get him an 11-point lead in that first half. With the quick hands of Gill, he has given Long all he wants on the perimeter.
He sure has.
Trying to get himself free, and he's out of gas and turns it over again. Great work by Kristavius Gill. Keep an eye on 14 White, Eric Thomas. Scored 10 of New Orleans' final 16 points in that first half. Almost a pick by Wilson. Thibodeau. Oh, my goodness! Thibodeau with a throwdown.
T-squared tried to tear it off.
A vicious dunker is Thibodeau. And he shows that game right there. But a pull-up pop short. Long's been very quiet. He's starting to get anxious trying to get in this game.
Exactly.
Gill pulls it. No. And out of bounds off of Mauro Sala. State and Clark, let me bug you for your final four. You got some predictions at this point?
I do. And I'm going to stay with what I said just 2 days ago during the selection show. I love Villanova's intangibles and their skill level. The Bruins scored as easy as any team that I've seen in college basketball. Louisville, I think, has the highest ceiling of any team, perhaps in the tournament. And then Gonzaga may be the most balanced team when you look at inside, outside, offense, defense, depth, experience, all of those things Gonzaga has.
Well, Final Four will be in Phoenix. We'll be out west once again for the first time in a long time since the late 90s. And you're well represented with teams from the west. Shot clock into single digits now. Well, New Orleans has missed their last 8 field goals. Block with 4 on the timer. And reset the clock. You're watching the big dance, and it calls for big refreshment. So grab a delicious ice-cold Coca-Cola and enjoy the game. Coca-Cola, taste the feeling. The first four and the first matchup of the NCAA tournament. 68 teams, 67 games to crown a champion in Phoenix. And that is a big hit for New Orleans. Nate Frye snaps 8 consecutive misses for New Orleans. New Orleans is not a three-point shooting team, as Clark alluded to in the first half. They attempt among the fewest in Division I basketball. That's a foul from behind on Frye with Robinson on the take.
Yeah, they attempt 14 a game and make only 4 a game, B.A. Here you see Frye recognizing his defender is backed off of him. That's what I call a warm-up jump shot. And he knocked it down.
And a long 2 there from Frye.
Yep.
So New Orleans has still missed 8 consecutive threes after they hit the first one of this game. Robinson, normally a very good free throw shooter. As a matter of fact, he led the Northeast Conference in free throw shooting this year at 87%. Misses the first.
Well, I sense that the privateers trying to grab control of this game, with Long being locked up pretty well by Gill defensively for the most part. Oh, nice steal by Wilson on a careless pass by the privateers.
Wilson has 2 steals now and a long-range bomb by Alexander. Greg Alexander delivers a 3-pointer.
That's what you call shaking some salt in that wound there. Get the pilfer and then spray it from deep right away.
On the take, Fry rattles it home. Count the basket. Chance at 3 for the senior guard, Nate Fry, backup point guard. And a good answer after the 3-ball from Alexander.
Fry is a guy who can give you offense in bunches, and there you see him taking the contact, concentrating on finishing. So often you see BA guys get bumped and then forget about concentrating on the shot. Good job there by Fry to keep his attention on the hoop.
And he can't convert the 3-point try. Normally a very good free throw shooter. Missed opportunity for New Orleans. Winners of the Southland Conference. Nice little shake. And Ray passed it up. Robinson will reset it now. 13 on the shot clock. Robinson pulls it up and hits it.
And he's so good attacking that big guy in the ball screen there. Got his body into him and then stopped on the dime.
All the way in. Fry, little spin. Wow, what a shot. Nate Fry putting a little English off the window to score. I'd say Murray's quickly back, looking inside for Ray. And a bad pass. He's calling for a deflection. Officials look at each other. That'll be out on Mount St. Mary's. New Orleans ball.
Fry going on a little solo spurtability run. That time right to the rim.
Averages over 10 a game. Fry has scored 8 of the last 10 for New Orleans.
Now he's defending Long, who's had a tough time shaking loose.
Can't get one to go. Eli Long, he's normally their best player, has not scored in this game. That's only his second shot attempt and his first 3-point try.
Yeah, part of that is the defense that's been played on him. He also sat quite a bit in the first half with the 2 fouls. Settled for a jump shot there and not a quality look for the privateers. And then Wilson and Robinson have had it going so well, B.A., that Long hasn't gotten any opportunities.
And now Robinson on the take, scored again.
This little fella's putting on the show, boy.
And 1, Junior Robinson gives him 18 now. And that combo of Robinson and Wilson with 33 points combined tonight.
Well, he's got such body control, excellent quickness, and you talked about his bounce ability at 40-inch vertical. Excellent concentration there, but this little fella is packing a lot of game in that small frame.
Made 5 threes in the NEC championship game, was all tournament. Rattles it home, 3-point possession for Mount St. Mary's.
A big one too, because I felt like the privateers were starting to get some traction. And then just as quickly, the Mount gets a little mini surge themselves.
That was Ray with the block on Thomas. And now Fry scores, so they got it back after the block. And Fry has now added to it. He scored 10 of the last 12 for New Orleans. 4-point game.
High ball screen. They're going to run this quite a bit. One of the things that makes Mount St. Mary so tough is that they've got closers like Long and Robinson. Tough miss that time by Long, but they're excellent free throw shooters and penetrators. So when they get on the lead, the ball's in their hands an awful lot.
Ooh, a rocket off the window for Nate Fry.
My goodness.
Add 2 more to the picture.
Fry is sizzling.
now 13 of the last 16 for New Orleans. Robinson, a to turn the corner. Good matchup. Two of the three shortest players in Division I basketball guarding each other, Hill, Gill, and Robinson. And he beats him on the dribble, but it's swatted away, and that's going to be a turnover. Well, I tell you, Kristavius Gill can play some D for New Orleans. Great emotion. These two teams trying to get the slingshot in the threes, and while there are 10 on the floor, Clark, it feels like two guys have stepped up in a big way here lately.
A pair of fellas deciding to solo dance. Junior Robinson, 11 of his team's last 14, and Fry stirring it up. Get busy, Nate. He scored 12 of his team's last 14. And they've done it all manner of way. And it's been good, both sides.
Fry's a backup point guard. He comes in, he's given them 13 points, has three rebounds as well. It's New Orleans ball. Mount St. Mary's leads it by two. 12 in the second half for Nate Fry.
Been a while since the Privateers have had a lead, B.A.
Well, good take there.
Thibodeau, the lefty, with the jump stop in the bucket. And New Orleans has evened it up. Down 11 midway through the first half. We're on a 10-2 run to finish the first half. And now they have squared the deal. Robinson on the move again, and he stops and pops. A little floater in the lane from Robinson. He keeps it going. That's now 13 of the last 16 points.
Showtime.
Two-point lead for the Mount. And Thomas, top scorer for New Orleans. Averages 19 and a half a game. He scored 12. Here's Thibodeau running into a wall, and the lefty fires one off the glass. It's good.
Good patience and footwork that time by Thibodeau. Boy, both of these teams executing at a high level. Expect the ball to be in Robinson's hands pretty much most of the possession. He's been so good at getting into the paint and getting into the shot he wants.
Robinson kicks it long. Checked quickly there by Broyles. A long little step back, three-point shot, short. Long continues to be held in check.
Well, sometimes, B.A., when you have to sit with the fouls, it's hard to recapture your rhythm or to ignite your rhythm. And the defense has been outstanding on Long by a number of different privateers.
Thomas can't get it to go. Long lost it out of bounds. That's going to stay in the possession of New Orleans. Somebody got a hand in there. I believe it was Thibodeau.
It was.
Hey, a reminder, you can play the official bracket game of NCAA March Madness. The Capital One NCAA March Madness Bracket Challenge is ready for your picks. So get your bracket started now at NCAA.com or in the March Madness Live app. There's a steal. Long on the move is fouled by Thomas. So a frustration foul after he was picked. And if you're Elijah Long right now and you're having a tough time scoring a basket, that's an area you can show up and make a difference on the defensive end.
That's right. He just jumped in the passing lane. Careless pass that time by Thomas. And he'll take a break.
Thomas has not scored in this second half. And he'll go to the bench with 12.
I don't know if Thomas has taken a shot. Actually, only one shot this half, B.A. He's only had one field goal attempt. And again, Mark Schlesinger told us that he's not a guy that looks to hunt his shot. He'll wait until the opportune time.
Gonna get Fry on the foul. That's the sixth team foul now.
That's a big number because you know the ball is going to be in the hands of Long and Robinson, both excellent free throw shooters and guys that can get to the lane off that high ball screen.
A lot of game to play with free throws the rest of the way. Ray gets himself free, kicks it, ball's popping. Alexander drops one. Greg Alexander hits his second three in transition quickly off the make is Broyles. So before Mount St. Mary's could catch a breath, a quick two by the Privateers.
Well, that was excellent execution both ways. The ball movement for the three by the Mount and then the quick inbound to the hoop.
Long on the take. That's what he does. He is a blow-by guard and gets to the hole that time with ease.
And close games is where it really helps to have 2 point guards that can get shots themselves, score the ball, or get other people's shots and make foul shots when they get fouled. So it's going to be tough for the privateers from here if they can't get a lead.
Zeno, no, a little mid-range. Well, Eli Long scoring his first basket of this game. He is their top scorer, MVP of the NEC tournament. Double team comes. And he gets to the hole. Up and under he goes. There he is.
Tell you what, it's going to be really hard, B.A. These two guys are slippery and clever and fearless. And with the lead, they can close you out if you can't find a way to stop.
Thibodeau bullies his way in. Ray hit the deck. Thibodeau answers on the other end. 3-point game. New Orleans down with the ball here. A check of Mount is up with the ball. Long and Robinson, the two dynamic guards.
Zone defense here, B.A., because they have had such difficulty with that ball screen. Nice change of pace here by Mark Schlesinger.
Wilson jumps to the middle. Can't hit. So the zone turns into a missed opportunity. Let's see if New Orleans can answer now, down three.
Well, that zone negated the dribble penetration that possession.
Up top. Thibodeau kicks it. Nice pass, but did he step out of bounds? No, 3 seconds. Takes us to a timeout. 58-55, 6:36 remaining, and we got a little skirmish between Gill and Thibodeau here. So the pressure and the tension of this NCAA tournament. I'm sure they're brothers, but right now they're not happy with each other. New Orleans, Clark, between Thibodeau and Gill.
Yeah, I think Thibodeau was upset that maybe he didn't get the ball soon enough, and it appears that he says, I've been open, and they were close to dropping hands there. Now let's see if they can regroup and galvanize together. You see Thibodeau is out of the game. Gill defending Junior Robinson. Back to the man-to-man, it looks like, for the Privateers. They went one possession of zone to try to negate this dribble penetration.
Lost out of bounds by Wilson. You saw that graphic come by. 6 turnovers in the half for St. Mary's. Or rather, check that, for New Orleans. St. Mary's forcing the 6. That is the context that led up to the turnover, the 3-second violation, and that altercation. Oh, my goodness, Alexander delivers again. Greg Alexander has been hot from 3-point range. He's hit 3 of them tonight.
He's a 36% shooter from there on the season, B.A., and he has stepped into all of his looks with great confidence tonight.
Now 15 points off 6 forced turnovers from Mount St. Mary's. A turnaround. Poe, he's got it.
Nicely done.
Second time he's hit that shot in this game.
Well, it looks like it's going to be 3s and dribble penetration from Mount St. Mary's. And trying to throw that ball inside for the Privateers. But the more you have to go out to shooters, the more vulnerable you are to dribble drive if you can't contain the ball one-on-one.
Well, another great defensive play by Gill. He's had 2 of those picks on Robinson. Turnover for the Mount. On the take goes Zeno, strong to the hole.
Michael Zeno.
Just like that, New Orleans. Back within a pair as we approach the 5-minute mark in regulation here in Dayton. 13 turnovers for the Mount, and all those points off turnovers for New Orleans.
Yep, that's been the story for the Privateers. They've cashed in when they've gotten turnovers.
Eli Long wants to take it himself. Wow, gets right by Fry, up and under, no good. Gill wants to push it. Gill loses the handle. And it looked like Gill touched it last. That'll be Mount St. Mary's basketball. Hey, a reminder, you can follow Bleacher Report on Instagram. Get the coolest sports content before anyone else. Join millions of others and follow Bleacher Report on Instagram now. Top scorer for New Orleans back in. Eric Thomas Zeno will sit, and this will probably be the group that rides the rest of the way. Very curious to see how Mark Schlesinger is going to use Thibodeau here the rest of this game. There's a steal. Nope, Wilson got it back. And now in a scramble. Long passes the three. Oh, my goodness, gets through the double team and scores a layup.
My goodness. I tell you what, this duo of Robinson and Long, despite their size, they wreak havoc offensively.
That was a very small window to get through. And that's going to be a block on the floor. No shot. Check this out.
This is a dancing eel. Elijah Long. Now look at this jump, stop, spin, slither, slight crack, and to the rack.
It's a great look from our crew. That super slow mo. The late reaction. Oh, and one. Fry to the hole scores. You could hear the clap on the hand. And Fry with a chance at a three-point play.
Man, he's been superb off the bench. Here he is again, just using that strong body, working through contact. Miles Wilson guilty of the bump.
Fry has 14 points in this second half. 15 for the game. Can add one to it here. He's a good free throw shooter. And this time he does cash in on the three-point possession. 1 point game. Mount St. Mary's with the lead and the ball. Under four to go.
And Brian, we're seeing here what I think we're going to see throughout the tournament. Highly competitive games throughout the bracket, regardless of seeds.
Robinson will pull it back. Love this matchup here with Gill and Robinson. Gill's already picked him twice. Missed him that time. And now jumps the lane. He's going to be out of bounds. But Kristavius Gill is all over the floor right now. Even when he gets beat, he's making plays. We're set up for a dandy, folks. 3.5 to go in Dayton.
Keeping his chest on the ball, getting a couple of strips. And he's going to need that. He's got 5 filches.
Almost got that one. 5 on the shot clock with Gill's work, who stepped on the baseline. Now thrown away, and a turnover for Mount St. Mary's.
Could be the opportunity that the Privateers are looking for. Have not led. It's been a while, B.A., since UNO has been on the lead.
UNO a chance here. Down a point.
I think you try to find Thomas. Run whatever set you can to try to get him to go to work.
And Thomas is fouled. Alexander on the block.
Only the 16 foul, so both teams with 16 fouls now.
4 fouls on Alexander, by the way. He's been hot. He's made 3 big threes for the Mountaineers. And with that in mind, Otto Sala is in for Alexander. And you could see an offense-defense scenario down the stretch. They need Alexander shooting.
They're going to need defense on Eric Thomas, because I think that's exactly where the Privateers are going to go when it's time to get a shot.
Got to go to the early reaches of the first half to find the last New Orleans lead. Off the back iron, Fry can't hit, and now the bounce could add to it.
Pretty good look, though, for a guy who's played extremely well in this second half.
Fry has 15 points in the second half. All but one of his points on the board coming in half number two. Under 3 to go. Winner will take on Villanova in Buffalo Thursday night on CBS. And they'll enter into the full field as a 16 seed. Robinson, shot clock to 1 and a travel.
That's great defense. That is textbook platinum level lockdown defense right there. Take a look at these guys move their feet. Nate Fry first. Long can't get by him. And then there's Kristavius Gill, who's been an absolute blanket defensively.
Just check that New Orleans bench. Thibodeau continues to sit after that skirmish with Gill. And Thomas dropped an elbow. That's going to be an offensive foul. It's going the other way. Third foul on Thomas.
Really nice job by Chris Ray here. Just a little bit of a shoulder bump by Thomas earned him the foul. can't dislodge a guy with any part of your body when you're handling the ball.
Alexander's back on the floor. Most nights, Mount St. Mary's can get by their defenders with their guards. That has not been the case here tonight. And there's a foul. Wilson did get by his defender. And a swat on the right hand will send Wilson to the free throw line. Broyles picks up number 3. Team fouled number 8 for New Orleans. And a 2-shot foul here for the freshman from Baltimore, Miles Wilson. This is the first. Basketball star Chris Webber, my March Madness partner, moving on after this. He's giving his famous athlete friends a chance to prank their most hardcore fans. Chris Webber's Full Court Pranks, all new Mondays, 10, 9 Central, only on Chew TV.
Missed them both there. And a tight one, obviously. Need them all.
Yet another chance for New Orleans to take the lead. And Mark Schlesinger wants a timeout. The Privateers will draw one up. 2 minutes, 1 second left in regular. Oh, it makes sense. Right out of the gates, our first game of the 67 we will play. And our game reset, Clark.
Yep, there you see the fouls, both teams in the bonus. And
Thibodeau continues to sit. After a little altercation with his teammate Gill. Gill has been impressive defensively. New Orleans trying to take the lead for the first time since the first 5 minutes of the game. And it is Gill, and he is fouled. Free throws for Kristavius Gill.
Excellent curl that time from the weak side to the ball side there by Gill.
We hit the air tonight talking about this matchup having two of the three shortest players in NCAA Division I basketball. Gill is the third shortest at 5'8". We got Robinson at 5'5", and they've both made huge impacts in this one. And we are all tied up now at 63.
Yeah, we are, and the middle guy of that diminutive triumvirate is Keon Johnson from Winthrop. And this could be the first lead in a while, and it is.
Since the 15:05 mark of the first half, when it was 10-7, New Orleans has grabbed the lead once again. And now we'll see if Mount St. Mary's has an answer.
Mismatch here.
They clear it out.
Yep,
Zeno is
exactly
on him.
What they're going to do.
And now Robinson off the foot of Zeno, gets it back and drops it in. Stayed poised, gives Mount St. Mary's the lead once again. 1:20 remaining in regulation here. New Orleans has not won an NCAA tournament game since 1987. On the tape, too strong. Broyles, and a whistle.
Wow.
They're going to get Thomas.
Wow.
Which is going to send Wilson to the free throw line.
Not a smart move there. I don't know why Thomas is reaching in. You don't have a chance for the offensive rebound. Let's get back and play defense. Plenty of time on the clock. You don't want to provide 3 points. And Junior Robinson, so valuable to have guards that can make plays and make shots. And Junior's been doing it all game long. 15 of his 23 here in the second half.
Wilson on the line. Normally good. Finally gets one to go. He struggled from the free throw line tonight. He's 3 for 7 now. Shoots it at 75%.
D.A., we talk often about the importance of guards in the tournament as Wilson pries another one in, because you get into situations like this, really good guards can get you home, just like a closer and pitcher in baseball.
Who's going to take the big shot for New Orleans? They get it into Thomas. That's going the other way.
Wow.
An offensive foul. And I believe it's going to be on Gill.
I think you're right. Trying to set a screen to free up Eric Thomas.
Oh, it could be a cost. So Damian Christian And the Mountaineers in control right now. 3-point lead with the ball, and their two dynamic guards in Long and Robinson. Robinson has been a star tonight. Junior Robinson with 23 points. He's hit three threes. He's only missed four shots all night.
Pressure here by the Privateers. It's hard to pressure these two guys, Long and Robinson. But good ball handlers with speed and quickness. Don't need a shot.
Wilson had it picked, gets it back, trying to get a timeout. The ball is on the floor, and New Orleans comes away with it. Long was desperate to try to call a timeout, but the ball was on the floor.
I like the fact that there was no timeout called. Wilson didn't quite have secure possession as he was attempting to call the foul as I saw it live. Let's look at the replay. Deflection. And he didn't have it. He did not have it when he tried to call the timeout, and Fry snuck in and took it from him because he didn't have it securely.
It's good work by Brent Hampton. You have a player come at you like that calling a timeout, the distraction of the player in your ear, and let the play unfold as it was. So first they're going to take a look to see if this is a flagrant, and then they have the ability to go to the monitor as well to determine which player the foul was on. So there's no question there will be a foul here.
There's Fry with it, and there's a reach in. I think that's just a common foul.
Yeah, Charles Glover.
Yeah.
Looked like he got him on the arm.
Yeah, I think it actually fouled him a couple of times there, the initial one, and both actually were just common fouls.
So it works as a timeout for these two coaches. And it's going to be New Orleans basketball here. The flagrant part of this, I don't think it'll go that way, but if it does go that way, that could completely change this one. And now the call comes.
Yeah, it's
just
a common foul. Right, right. And a nice job by the officials. Didn't take unnecessary time.
Jeb Hartness and Steve McJunkins taking a look. Steve kind enough to come over. What do you offer?
Common foul. Number three is going to get shots. The one and one.
And a foul on Glover.
Yep, Glover with the common foul, as we thought.
34.2 remaining in regulation. Fry, chance to pull the Privateers within one. And his big second half continues.
This is a great basketball venue. Sight lines are good. Intimacy of the facility, but also soft shooting rims, Brian.
Yeah, nice.
Really nice soft rims.
And two for two is Fry. 1-point game. Just the way you want March Madness to start.
Last possession now. No need to foul. Defend. See if you can force a turnover or a tough shot.
Young with a double team. Stuck in the corner down there. And Glover able to get it ahead to Robinson. 3 seconds plus separating shot clock and game clock.
Boy, you almost might. Man, that's really tight. You probably need the foul here, I would think, now, Brian.
Robinson, the best free throw shooter in his conference with the basketball. And we're going to play it straight up. Clock ticks. Down to two on the shot clock. Big shot coming. No. Rebound is there from New Orleans. Timeout called by Thomas. And with 2.6 left, the Privateers of New Orleans will have a chance to win this game and advance into the full field to take on Nova.
Well, I'm thinking foul there because you give yourself a chance, even with two made free throws, to have more time. But they played it right to the wire. Good, solid defense, force a tough shot, and then the rebound by Thomas and the quick timeout. And they chose to max it out. That's right on the line based on the amount of time. And without the ability to advance the ball in the college game, 2.6 is enough time, but it's not ideal for going the length of the court. So that's the reason I suggested maybe looking at the foul earlier. That way it's maybe a 3-point game and you've got 6-7 seconds perhaps, and there's no guarantee the foul shots are made. So
New Orleans has used their final timeout. What a way to start the NCAA tournament. This is fantastic.
And Brian, I tell you, I really believe we're going to see a lot of these kinds of games, in part because outside of the Power Five conferences, there are 27 other conferences. And I counted in those other 27 conferences, 15 are represented by their championship teams that also won the regular season. So high quality teams in this tournament. In this situation now, 2.6 seconds, you've got to try to advance it with the pass as deep as you can, and you're going to try to get it. Eric Thomas is going to inbounds the ball, it looks like. Sure handed. So you're going to probably try to do something with Gill and his speed, or Fry. A catch around half court and then see if they can make a play.
NCAA tournament ended in a moment like this with Chris Jenkins last year. We may get it started the same way. Baseball pass, no, turned it over, and the clock ticks, and the game is over. And Mount St. Mary's is moving on. The Mountaineers out of the NEC hang on to beat New Orleans. The pass inbounds too tall, and a turnover finishes the game in this great run by Mark Schlesinger and the Privateers.
Well, the receiver was open. The pass was just way too high. And if you don't catch it cleanly with that little time on the clock, it's a wrap.
And you can bet the decision to not foul in that last Mount St. Mary's possession, let the clock get under 3 seconds, will certainly come up. So Mount St. Mary's has their date. There has never been a 16 seed beat a 1 seed in the NCAA tournament. They're going to get their chance in history Thursday night on CBS as they take on the overall number 1 seed, the Villanova.